Hello everyone, thanks for stopping by my channel. Today's card features stamps and dies from Hello Bluebird, and as always I used a lot of images to create this cute scene. If you follow me for some time, you know that the first thing I like to do is to stamp my images. And if I plan to use my alcohol markers, I always stamp them on Nina Solar white cardstock using Memento Tuxedo Black ink. A quick note about my Spectrum Noir videos. The first one will be published next Wednesday, the second one on the Wednesday after, and the third one on the Wednesday after. You can notice that I left the t-shirt blank for a while. I just didn't know which color to use, but I ended up choosing red, like the water lilies, because I think it coordinates pretty well with khaki green. While you're watching me color, I also wanted to tell you that I will have a giveaway here on my channel. I'm waiting for the prize to arrive, but it will be very soon, so stay tuned. I die-cut a skating pond scene from Bristol cardstock and decided to make some changes. I wanted to have two grass sections at the top and bottom of the pond. So I took another piece of Bristol cardstock, die cut grass elements, and used the pieces I wanted to change as guides to trim the edges. Next, I colored all the background elements. Ponds never look like blue lagoons, so I used shabby shutters and broken china distressings to color it. The grass elements were colored using shabby shutters distress ink as a base and peel pend distress ink for shadows and depth. I took the same inks and splattered some drops on the grass elements using a small brush to add more texture and interest to the scene. Gathered twigs and ground espresso were used to color the trees. On a Bristol panel, I traced pencil marks to know exactly where to color the sky using tumble glass all over and broken china at the top. Next, I attached the sky panel to a white card base. Then I stuck all the background elements down the pond using double-sided tape. And the grass elements using 2 mm foam adhesive squares. The trees were also attached using 2 mm foam adhesive squares. You can notice on the left a scallop border. It's meant to be used as foliage and was colored using the same process and colors as the grass elements. Off camera, I white hit embossed my sentiment at the very top of the panel and added white highlights to the images, and next I attached them. Some were glued using 1 mm and 2 mm foam adhesive squares, some using glue dots, depending on where I wanted to place them. I've made another fishing card inspired by this one using L'Enfant supplies. I will share it very soon, so I hope you'll be there. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye!